Hello everyone and welcome back to the Keep Productive YouTube channel. It is Francesco here, and in today's video we will be diving into my Things 3 tour. I wanted to show you around, talk a little bit about why I've moved from Todoist after 8 to 9 years of using it. Then I want to talk about how I'm exactly using it, including projects, including layouts, and all the stuff that you might need to know if you're using Things 3 as a little bit of inspiration or a way that I do something that might help you. So if you're new here, it'd be great to have you as a subscriber, so make sure to hit subscribe and do check out the Keep Focus community, which we're doing some fun stuff within. You can join below and it'd be great to have you there. So as you can see in front of me, this is Things 3. I have been using it for about 3 months. I've sort of surpassed the 90-day sort of trial period that I give most applications. If I try them, I really rarely do try them. And this only came about because I was struggling so much with Todoist and my own sort of Notion use. And as you can imagine, remember, I moved over to Evernote from Notion. And it came at a time when I was trying to minimize the tools, and I found quite a good base on Things 3. The main reasons I want to talk through are sort of three core reasons. The first is the way that my day is more structured. So for example, my day is a lot more sort of 50-50 personal work. So being able to have separations to that is quite important for me. And what the feature that really drew me in for that was this evening feature, which if you see here, when you press when, you can pop open this evening as an option, which is perfect because that's tend to be when I clock off and I can do other stuff around the house, you know, everyday routine stuff. And I'm able to sort of separate that from the day stuff. The second feature that sort of drew me in is this grouping ability. So even if I moved this to say today, you can see that it groups it based on project, which I really like. So if I open today, I can see that quite neatly organized on what tasks I have. I really like the minimalist style. I can drop away that side menu and just have it clean in front of me. So as you can see, it's quite nice for that because I have daily tasks for the regular stuff I do every single day with work, and I have routine for stuff around the house. The third feature I'd say is probably projects. So if I go over here to my projects, I have two main projects at the moment is like launch a 2 solo courses and reach 1 million views in 30 days, which will be a little bit tougher. But as you can imagine, going into these projects, I like to actually go inside and sort of plan them, break them down into headings, make some notes on them, and add a deadline as well. And that's something that I felt that Things 3 is much better at, personal project management. And it helps me also to separate it quite neatly into areas away from the personal stuff. So I've really liked having this set up. And actually, it's really helped me to separate work and personal a lot better than I was doing before inside of Todoist, even at sort of my peak Todoist time. So as you can imagine, I'm still using it in the same way I used Todoist. So let me start you with Inbox and say move down the list through this sort of sidebar. So with Inbox, across the day, I'm just sort of clipping stuff. It can be really random stuff, like from articles that I want to read to things I want to check out, maybe buy, to ideas that I've had. Across the day, I'm just clipping them in. The mobile app works really great with the really fast, when you drag it into the Inbox. I love that feature. So the Inbox has become like this hub for me. I'm not using, I say, with any sort of extensions or anything like that. It's just plain and simple. So set up here, and I use Command P on the Mac to quickly dump something in there over the top of doing some other piece of work. So I'm always capturing stuff. And then at the end of the day, at say 4 p.m., I tend to just organize this into the relevant areas. If I actually don't get around to doing it, what I tend to do nowadays is just press Control A, and that just selects it all, and I just drag it into any time. And that's mainly because I can then do a bigger processing session, and it keeps that inbox clear to dump in new ideas for the day and allows me to sort of action and sort that all out later. Versus seeing the sort of check mark there of like, okay, you've got 23 things in there, it would then go up to say 50 and I'd be like, oh my God, that's a lot of stuff. So that's my sort of methodology with the inbox. It's not say GTD, but it definitely resonates GTD with the capturing side of stuff. So today is obviously where most of the tasks get done for the day. So for example, with this say Tesco order, I tend to do this if I'm trying to break it up a little bit more, pop that in this evening. And you can see here, like for example, daily tasks, last thing on my list here today, is the Things 3 tool which I'm doing now. So as you can imagine, it's like a really simple setup. I'm not using anything advanced, I'm using the deadline abilities. I use the tags really occasionally, and that's if I've got more than four things on my list, I go down to, where is it, focus, or no, highlights, and you can see here that highlights tag appears next to it. Then if there's a very long list of stuff to do, that's where I can sort of narrow down the three things I wanna do during my day. I've been doing the three things I wanna do during my day for the since maybe middle of December. So basically that is when I do my journal in the morning, I write down three things that if I wanna get done during the day, like highlights, and that helps me to navigate the minimalist style of things really more than I did before. So when I'm in here, I have three core focuses for the day, and allows me to get things done better than I did before, which hopefully is, like helping me keep focused and keep sort of going towards the right goal. Now, the one thing that I do is when I open upcoming, if I'm trying to plan the next few days ahead, I'll use the new windows area, and I tend to have like today on the left and upcoming on the right. I'll make this one smaller. And what you can do between the windows is drag them, which I really like. So for example, if I'm like, if I'm in any time and I'm like, okay, right, these look a little bit more actionable than they are. What I'll do is I can drag them into the relevant areas on a week review. So that tends to be on like a Thursday afternoon, and it helps me plan the week in advance, but literally allows me just to drag stuff in without any sort of stress. I really like that ability. Very subtle, very easy to use. I used to actually have the calendar events pop up here, but I even found just having it as tasks only is quite nice, and sort of keeping an idea. But I can always have the calendar down here open at the same time to see what's actually on for the day. So I really like the way that this upcoming is viewed. It's quite non-intrusive to today, and I really like that. You know, there's really nothing wrong to Todoist, but the next 7 days, I guess, sometimes can be quite overwhelming, and having that sort of separation helps to keep focused. So the really cool thing with anytime as well, so I'll do like an anytime clear out every 2 days, 3 days, if there's anything in there, is anything that doesn't have an associated date goes inside of here. So for example, like if I'm just like, okay, like there's stuff that I need to get done inside of the project side of stuff, and they're static, they're not got a date associated to them, I can actually go in and see them. Same with reading, same with other stuff like that. They can be done anytime. There's no deadlines on them, and it helps me to, I guess, to go down here and sometimes just like weave out what needs to be done. So someday I have it broken into two areas. I have it associated to a project, which is called 2021 Goals, with a few things that I'd like to get done during the year. Like New Year's resolutions always, they're all there, and that's really nice to see. I can go to that project if I want to, but these are all someday ones. So again, they're things that can be done in the future, very general. And there are some, I guess just above here, sort of medium, short-term to medium goals. So for example, in this case, like things like car finances, net keeps projects, you know, what I want to do next, like booking an Airbnb getaway when we can. So that someday is quite nice because it gets me to look at like future stuff. So I'd say the top bit is short term, the next bit is long term, and that's really nice. Now, I didn't really use the logbook whatsoever. Trash, again, the same. I have that thing to be cleared out instantly. The projects, as I said, is fairly simple. I didn't keep them too difficult, but it's actually really nice to have like a place to plan them and organize them in a very relaxed fashion. The real magic is inside of the personals area. So for example, I have different tasks for, you know, like Otto, and I can go over to like the routine, and this is all the stuff that I've got set up. So for example, like bins, call my grandpa, pay pension, things like that, that I've got coming up. So this is where a lot of my sort of time goes into as well. So it's just being able to use that as a sort of planning board. I use it as my reading list as well. So sometimes if there's like some longer articles or even notes that I'm taking, say for example, like fitness notes that I want to do in my next sort of planning session, then I'll store them in the to read section. It's just handy to find them there. And I have sometimes like to clear reading list on certain days to get rid of them. Again, daily tasks is a place for me to just extract things that I'm pretty routinely gonna do. I actually just did that. but you can see it, lovely sort of syncing there. But I really like this because it keeps me very simple in what I'm gonna do during the day. Whereas the projects are more where I get the majority of my work done because that it helps me to keep focused on that project. This daily task area is really handy for that. Now, I really love the area side of stuff. So having the ability to have area and then the lists below it, that's something that I would say is something that I didn't really like inside of Todoist. It's something that, you know, having those drop downs, but it just, what it does is it neatens it up much further than it does inside of Todoist. And that's all it is. It makes it just easier to be able to use on a daily basis. So in terms of my planning and that sort of sign of stuff, as I said, I tend to capture a lot of stuff in inbox, process anytime every 2 days to see what tasks I need to do in the next coming stuff. And that really helps when I'm getting sort of bombarded by emails or work and I just want to be able to defer it or even just capture it for later to be able to process. Particularly helpful when I'm trying to focus on the 3 things that I've done during the day. Other stuff tends to go in inbox or any time, unless it's super, super urgent and I need to get to it. But quite luckily, I haven't had those for maybe a while now, maybe because it's January and it's still fresh as the new year begins. Now, I just want people to know that I really still respect Todoist a lot. I think it's a fantastic application and the board's abilities was definitely something that was great. I think I just needed a bit of a change of scenery and the way that I was using applications, I just was slimming down on them and I wasn't utilizing the majority of Todoist features like labels, filters, and also even boards to some extent. I wasn't really taking advantage of them, if that makes sense. And I just found like this has been a lot more of a cooler, relaxed setup for me, especially when managing personal and work at the same time. So I'm very grateful to have spent a bit of time just working that out. As I said, I think I definitely warranted being able to move because I have been using it for such a long time to do this. That at the same time, it gave me a lot of time to think about why and how I'm moving. And this is a really great move, I think, both over to Evernote and both over to Things 3. Despite Evernote's bugs, it allowed me to just think about what are the core tools I use and why should I use them. So that's something I'd definitely recommend doing if you're someone that just uses tools just because you use them for the sake of it and things like that. One final thing I like is I'm slowly learning the keyboard shortcuts, but I really like the quick find. That's something that I really like to do. So for example, like website upgrade, I tend to just like dump stuff in here as time goes on in the subtask, and that helps me to plan with next sessions. So again, just super simple, but really easy to use. You can see that example here, like with the community planning. You can see that it pops open up. I can see like all of the stuff that I've been having ideas on that I can still capture in advance. So super helpful. But yeah, that's my Things 3 layout, guys. I hope you enjoyed it and hopefully gave you some inspiration for your own setups. And whether you're applying it to your Things 3 or whether you're applying it to your own accounts, it'd be great to hear. Feel free to share your opinions in the comments below. Always good to hear what Todoist applications you're using. I think one thing I just continue to try and say is try and stay with it for as long as possible. I see myself potentially not moving from Things 3 for several years now, unless they come out with the Things 4, because it's sort of like the same systematic stuff. It's almost like, you know, if you got a new iPhone, it's gonna be the same base. you're not really moving necessarily like the way you're using the tool, unless it's drastically different, but I doubt it will be. But I hope you enjoyed today's video. Please do subscribe, and I look forward to chatting with you guys in the comments. But thank you very much, guys, and cheerio.